You know, I never have anything on my mind, as you use the expression something on your mind. I have responsibility, yet nothing hangs over me. Nothing weighs me down. First of all, I know that all is well. All is well is not just made-up words I use to give you or me a pep talk. That all is well is a literal fact. All is well right now, regardless of what you think. Whatever you may well dwell on and certify as tragic, you do not yet see as I see. You have yet to see through the disguise and banter of the world. You may hear me often enough as I say that all is well, yet, meanwhile, you are under stress and strain. Dear ones, ultimately, you put yourself through this stress and strain. You sanction the stress and strain. You say that appearance is true. You tell yourself, how I cannot be strained in the situation I am in. And so you set the dial of your life to stress and strain. Even where your life shows up as utterly amazing and wonderful, you don't believe in your good fortune either. You say this is too good to be true. You do not believe that you are Cinderella and stand on a firm foundation, yet you do firmly, even fiercely, believe in bad news. Of course, you call one layer of existence as realistic, as if you do not stand on a deep foundation where the idea of trouble can only be a misnomer. You are attached to your body with all your heart. You believe in and rely on the physical, yours and others, as if bodily existence is your gospel to go by. Just as the literal ocean on earth can have upheavals, the ocean deep also remains the ocean silent. There is a stability deeper and stronger than any monsoon ever dreamed of. You may not today reach the heaven I speak of. Still, you can believe that heaven exists and is for you, and one day, perhaps soon, perhaps all at once, or perhaps with a tiny taste at a time, you will reach a state of consciousness where literally nothing eats you up. It is not that you become masterful over your emotions and perceived frailties. No, the day arises when you simply no longer have fear to master. You come to where you recline in the ocean deep, and you know peace, regardless of surface tangencies. You become a transient solid on your feet. You simply know you stand firm on the scaffolding of life. You no longer make room for blown-up fear. You know you are as solid as a rock in my ocean of love. No longer can fear knock you off your feet, nor can the winds of change ruffle your hair anymore. Whenever you are emotionally wrought and you fear death and life alike in your heart, you still have a choice. You don't have to lock yourself up into that state of fear as if you have no choice. You have the choice of a direction to go in, beloveds. Come with me, and you will get the hang of it. You will literally forget fear and no longer be in the clutches of this inflated anonymous boogeyman named fear. If the boogeyman knew your true strength, he would shake in his boots, and you would laugh exceedingly. If fear continues to get to you and you shudder, then don't worry, for I stay with you, and you will come with me where fear cannot enter. Meanwhile, I am by your side. I wait with you. I don't leave you.